I'm going to show you how to edit a photo in Photoshop where we're going to get the maximum detail out of the sky and the foreground. So right now I'm starting in Lightroom, but I'll show you how to do it in Camera Raw in just a second. What I want to do is I want to bring out the maximum detail in this photograph. I want to bring out the detail from the original sky and the foreground. So what I'm going to do is, first of all, I'm going to duplicate this. I'm just going to hit Control or Command with the little hyphen. And what it's going to do is it's going to create a virtual copy. So on this virtual copy, I'm going to go to the develop module. And what I want to do is bring out the detail here in the sky, in the original sky. So let's recover all the highlights, drag them all the way back, and let's take our exposure down so we can see all the nice detail here in the sky. Yes, the foreground is getting a little bit dark, but it doesn't matter. Let me go to the other image here. This is our original. Notice we've got a little bit of blooming around here. Blooming means that, see how we're losing a little bit of edge detail because of the brightness? What we're going to do is just bring our highlights down just a little bit so we can see our edges clearly. That's great. And that's not going to overly affect our foreground. What I'm going to do though is I'm going to take the shadows and I'm going to open up these shadows a little bit just to bring out a little bit more detail in some of these trees and some of these different areas. So if we want to look at the two images now, I'm going to select both images and just in the library module here, I'll just bring them up and you can see I've exposed this one here for our shadow areas to open those up. I've exposed this one here for our highlight areas to open up our sky. And now what I want to do is I'm going to select both of these and I'm going to right click and I'm going to choose to edit in. But let's go down a little bit and we're going to open as layers in Photoshop. So let me just click OK. And now Photoshop is going to launch and it's going to have these on the layers. If you're not doing it inside of Lightroom or you don't have Lightroom, just go into Bridge, right click on the image and choose to duplicate. And then all you need to do is shift click on both of those. And then we right click and we choose open in Camera Raw. And now you have these images in Camera Raw, do the same adjustments we did before, and then just click done, or we can open them both inside of Photoshop. What we want to do is merge them together. And the easy way to do that is actually just to use the sky selection. So we don't want to replace the sky. We want to use the real sky. So with this top image selected, we're going to choose select, and then we will see sky. A lot of people miss that because they're so caught up in the sky replacement, but we can actually use this tool right here. All right, so it looks like we've got little bits in here that haven't been grabbed. So what we want to do is we want to expand this selection a little bit. So why don't we choose select and then choose similar. Now this is going to select the similar areas inside these little gaps here. Now you might get some areas that get missed. That's okay. We'll fix those. And also we've got some areas that probably shouldn't be selected here. For those areas that shouldn't be selected, grab the rectangular marquee tool. And what we want to do is we want to subtract them. So you could grab this subtract from selection option or just hold the alt or the option key. See the little minus, click down there, take some away. And now we're just selecting the areas we want. Great. Now what we're going to do is we're going to click on a layer mask. Now if we apply this layer mask, what it's going to do is it's going to select just the sky and hide everything else. We want the opposite of that. So to get the opposite, what you do is you hold down the Alt or the Option key, and that gives you the opposite of what you had when it comes to a selection when we're creating a mask. So Alt or Option, click on the mask. All right, so maybe the background's just a little bit strong. What we're going to do is we're going to select the mask, and there's an option in the layer mask that you may or may not have seen before. If we look in the properties, see the density. What density does is it reduces the effects of the mask. So watch what happens if I slide it all the way back. See, there's the mask not on. There's the mask on. But with density, we can roll it back. So we've got just a little bit of the mask. So we can roll in the amount of the sky that we want. So now it's mixing this top layer with the layer underneath. I think that looks a little bit more believable. All right, so we've got this little bit of blue up here. Well, let's have a look at the original image and see what's happening. So if we zoom in here, we can see, oh, that blue is actually in the original sky. Well, why don't we fix that? What we want to do is we want to make a selection around this area. So to make a selection, let's go back to our top layer. Make sure we're selecting the layer and not the mask. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to grab the magic wand tool. With the magic wand, anti-alias, let's set it to a tolerance of 30. Let's change it to a 5x5 average for the sampling. Make sure contiguous is turned off. And then we're going to select in here, and this should give us a selection of that area. Very, very nice. Now we're going to grab our mask and let's grab a brush, and we're going to choose black as the foreground color, and we can just paint that out. Now we're not done yet. There's some areas in here that maybe we want to add. Great. Don't turn off the selection just yet, because what we want to do is we want to go to the layer underneath, because if we look at it here, that blue is actually in the sky, but maybe I want to make it look more like a gray. So let's create a new layer in between the two layers. And I'm going to sample this gray. Hold down the Alt or the Option key, just, and that will give us an eyedropper. Notice that that foreground color now is gray. And if I paint in there, it'll just give us a nice gray. Control D will turn off that selection. And look at that, just merges in really nicely. Now, if we want to do a little bit more with this layer, why don't we create a curves adjustment above the middle layer? So let's go in here, we're going to create a curve. Now, the reason we're putting it between our top layer and these layers underneath is any adjustment I make now is just going to affect our sky area, but it's also going to affect our little patch that we did here. So let's play around with our contrast. Let's take our shadow area and pull it down just to darken the contrast a little bit in that area. And maybe pump it up a little bit in the highlights. And see how this just gives a little more contrast to those clouds. And if we wanted to give it a little color, like make it a little more blue, we could go under these colors, red, green, and blue. Let's go to our blue channel. And if we grab the middle here and we pull it up, notice it's going to give us more blue. If we pull it down, it's going to give us a more of a yellow or less of a blue. So why don't we go just more towards the shadow area? Just give a little touch of blue, not a lot. And you can see how that just really lifts the look of our sky there. And if you feel it's still a little fake, go back to our mask and turn that density back down a little bit more. And notice how we can just dial that in exactly where we want it. So I hope you learned something new here. If you did, let me know in the comments underneath. And by the way, I've noticed that only 20% of the people watching the videos are subscribed. So if you haven't yet subscribed, hit the subscribe button, turn on notifications, you won't miss any of my videos. If you like this, smash that like button. It helps with the YouTube algorithm. And until next time, I'll see you at the cafe.